we got to do to go racing? Here's a look at our line, 21X, Bob Roberts and the 15 of Cody Pritchett, the 2 of Frankie Beard, the 2 of Frankie Beard, the 14 of Jeff Robertson, the 23 of Honor Parkhurst, the 24D of Mark McLeod, the M19 Dexter Matthews, the Tommy Gandy, the K9 flag. Side by side, Pritchett and Roberts. Oh, look at there, Honor Parker's come on through. Are we gonna be able to make it? Happened. Our pole car has fell back. Bob Robertson fell to the back, but Pritchett has taken over. Honor Parker's is sitting in third. Robertson, Parkhurst. Anna coming up on the second place car. Bob Robertson having a tough run. Dino Long. Something must be wrong with the 21X cars. He is falling off the... But in the meantime, Pritchett has taken over the lead and over to 14 of Robertson. Honor Parkhurst is trying to close that gap. And we've got Frankie Beard in the 2 running 4. The K9 have been along sitting in 5th. Caution on the Speedway.
Green, green, green.
Person giving him a run in 3rd. Is she going to be able to sit it through again? But Frankie Beard is sitting in center to see if he can make that pass on Anna Parkhurst. Looks like a little bump in there between Beard and Parkhurst. Parkhurst is trying to place position back. She goes side by side with him to the flag stand, falls a little short. Beard is now your third place car. Connor Parker's in 4th. Dino Long sitting in 5th. Aikenson in 6th. 24 getting a little high out there. Gandy in 3rd, closing that gap. Stand with Beard. She's got the inside disc around it. That's going to pay off. They sit here and give each other little bumps. Now she is taking over 3rd. Now does she have what it takes to catch the 2nd place car now of Robertson? Position. Michael Exon, in the meantime, he's trying to see if him and Long. It looks like Robertson is starting to sit here and reel in Pritchett in the 15. Will he be the one to sit here and make up the distance? As Anna Parker seems like she is maybe falling off a little ways. Will we be able to run the rest of this event caution free? They're good and stretched out. We maybe can. Let's see what happens in the meantime. Done been caught by the 14 of Robertson. Jeff Robertson has caught Cody Pritchett. Let's see what's going to happen now. Anna Parkhurst, in the meantime, is starting to knock off some of that leeway in between those. And she is sitting there taking that real estate away from them, proving that she's got a fast car that can still move up the grounds. Frankie Beer still way off the pace in third place. Robinson, like he may have caught the wall or something and lost a little bit of distance. He may have lost some distance, but it gave Anna Parkhurst the move she needed to catch up on some of that real estate. Looked like the 31, Michael Exon, slower now, like he might be headed into the pits. Now, Parkhurst has caught Robinson. Is she going to have what it takes to get around him and take that second position away? Only time and laps will tell. We're getting ready. Five to go. Jeff Robinson sitting in second. Anna Parkhurst in third in the 23. Followed by the two of Frankie Beard and the K-9 of Beno Long. Those are your top five cars. This lap car, as we get ready to wind the laps down, stop gate guys, seats 1, 2, and 3, you should be in staging. Once you get over there, you will be lined up by what heat you're going in. So stop gate guys, you should all. So winding down. Robertson has done caught Pritchett. They've got the lap car of Matthews in front of them. Robertson, something has happened. He ended up losing some real estate, but Anna Parkhurst was able to peel it off. Is it going time? Dino Long has caught the two of Frankie Beard. Cody Pritchett, Jeff Robertson, Anna Parkhurst are your top three. Here comes the battle for four with Frankie Beard and Dino Long. Of Dino Long were your top five. The 602 last night at Dublin 441 Speedway to outside pole. But look who's on the inside pole with him, the number 23 of Anna Parkhurst. She starts the inside pole.
We'll be going green this time by.
All right, we will be going green. Anna Parkhurst coming off that second place finish.
Not fire
last car. Night at 441 Speedway in this same division. Just it wasn't a series, but Anna Parker, she's got the fire on this, so it's all up for her. Let's see what happens. Is Dale Timms going to be ready? Can Anna get the jump and get the lead on him and get a line that can hold him back? Let's see what happens. Green, green, green. She waits to the flag stand. Here we go. They go off into turn one. Can she hold him off? Dale Timms has fell back to third. Anna Parkhurst has went kind of high. Let's see what's going to happen. The number 14 of Robertson has fell into second place. Dale Timms in the third.
Caution, turn one.
Cranford in the one and fourth, but we've got a caution in turn one. Mr. Glenn Martin from the Wicker Barn has got the green flag in hand. Let's see what happens.
Green, green, green.
The green flag is out. Anna Parkhurst has fired. Let's see what happens. Can she hold it? Boy, they are fighting for that second position like you ain't never seen.
Caution.
Wow, the 14 of Robinson just took a bad hit. Anna Parkhurst has fired. Let's see what happened. Can she hold it? Boy, they are fighting for that second position like you ain't never seen.
Whoa. Caution.
Wow, the 14 of Robinson just took a bat.
Green.
And she is fired. And they're off. Benji Cranford. They are sitting there messing it up and battling out and doing whatever it takes. Let's see how it's going to look. followed by the 21C of Cameron Crow. Dale Timms is coming in third. Anna Parkhurst has dropped back to fourth. Parkhurst getting some competition from Rod Roberts. Dale Timms, he's trying to move into second place. Can he take it? He has taken over second place. In the meantime, Benji Cranford has stretched out that lead. Anna Parkhurst getting a run from Cameron Crow. He's pushing her. Let's see how she can do. She washes up a little bit to the high side. She's able to hold on to it. But she loses two spots in the process. And so now that seemed to be our washout spot back there. It's coming two going on to the back stretch. The two of Chris Wilbanks, he's kind of sitting back, kind of watching some of this action to make sure he don't get involved in none of that melee that could happen up in front of him. Anna Parkhurst is trying for the outside. Rod Roberts, she doesn't make it around. In the meantime, Cranford has stretched his lead, but Dale Timms is trying to walk him down. Like we said, Dale Timms has been winning a lot of these races lately. He is slowly making up that real estate. Cameron Crow has moved it up in third. Rod Roberts is in fourth. Anna Parkhurst is now has been dropped back to fifth. She seemed to be losing another position. You got to wonder if the Howland hadn't gone away on the 23 car. Ivana Parker. In the meantime, Dale Timms has caught Cranford, followed by Crow and Roberts.
You're clear to turn off, 23. Clear to turn off.
It's looking like Anna Parker has taken her to the pits. Something seems to be wrong. Cranford has got Timms slowly knocking on his door. Benji Cranford, the young gun in the 602 Sportsman class. Is he going to be able to hold off Dale Timms for this, as Dale Timms has been winded in that real estate? Cameron Crow in third, Roberts in fourth. Followed by Rusty House. Timms is on him. Timms has caught Cranford. Will he be able to get around him? Laps have got to be winding down. Here we go. We are getting the halfway mark. The halfway mark is on the board as Cranford is your halfway leader, followed by Timms. Crow, Roberts. All right, Rusty House is your fifth place car. Followed by the two of Chris Wilbanks. Okay, they're getting ready to close to come into lap traffic. Is this going to be where Dale Timms makes his move on the young gun of Benji Cranford? Let's see what's going to happen. If they're past the halfway point, they still have time to catch this slow car. Or is Benji Cranford going to be able to pull off and get his first win in the 602 Sportsman? Uh-oh. Look at there. Cranford has he washed up a little bit. Dale Timms has made up the real estate. He has closed the door in on him. Let's see what happens as they get ready to encounter lap traffic. Is Cranford going to be able to hold it as they go through the turn? Timms has caught him again. Timms washes up a little bit and loses a little bit of the real estate. Cameron Crow sitting back a good ways behind him in third position.
L5, they're coming up on you.
They have caught the L5. Here we go. Let's see what's going to happen. Is this where Dale Timms makes his move? Dale Timms has used the lap car and has made his way around to number one of Benji Cranford. Something seems to have happened to the two car, Chris Wilbanks. He has poured it down into the safe zone to keep from bringing out a caution. In the meantime, Dale Timms has stepped it up. He has caught Cranford, he has passed, but now he is showing why he is a dominating force in the 602 Thunder Series. Cameron Crowe has now caught the lap car of L5 as he sits there and tries to get around him. Cameron Crowe puts the L5 a lap down. Here we go. Crowe has done passed the lap car. Now Roberts gets ready to make his way around him as well. Let's see what's going to happen.
Let him go by. Thank you.
All right, here we go. They have seen people got themselves well separated from each other. Now it's going to be the driver's ability to try to catch one another. And they have sat there and separated. Each other's Rusty House has encountered the L5 and is getting ready to put him a lap down as well. Here we go. In the meantime, Dale Timms is picking him up, setting him down, and showing why he is the king of the 602 Thunder Series. He has got that car back on a rail after having numerous restarts for the cautions at the start of the race. Dale Timms has got it figured out at Modoc Raceway. Like you said, he has ran here in the crates before, so this is nothing new to him. Benji Cranford sits in second, Cameron Crowe in third, Rod Robertson fourth, Rusty House sitting in fourth. Here we go, white flag, your 602 of Dale. Looking like it's going to wind up being Dale Timms. It's going to be your 602 Thunder Series winner as he is sitting there picking up the real estate and knocking them down. Here we go, taking the checkered flag, two in a row. He won it at the Modoc 100 and now the 7th Annual Jack Shrett Memorial Race. Dale Timms in the 07 machine, followed by the 1 of Benji Cranford, the 21C of Cameron Crowe, and Rusty House is your top four. I tell you what, it was making you wonder. It's just a shame that something happened to Donna Parker. So she was showing that even as a young girl, she was ready for these guys.
Tyler Brown, you will be my start man. You start from that first cone to that second cone. Wallet does not jump him. If you do, you get one warning. If you do it again, you
and the four of Bubba Shaw.
Do not push.
The pile was not making it, neither is the seven of Mark Hughes. We have got our lineup and we are set to go. Like I said, we need to thank a lot of these fine sponsors for coming forward. Let's see who's going to pick that extra $500 cash put up by Tex Ron Offroad for our feature winner. But don't forget, we've got prize money in second, third, and fourth and fifth place as well. So let's see who's going to add $100 to their spot. Here we go. It's up to Tyler Brown. And he fires. Leaf Spring versus Coil Spring as they go into turn one. Fowler and Brown. Everybody bottlenecking up through the turns. Something has happened to the four car of Brown. Oh no.
Caution
is out. Caution is out.
Tyler, we see you, but we'll give you flat tire laps, sir. We'll give you flat tire laps.
Bad luck for Tyler Brown, our pole sitter. He's got a right front shoe down.
Green
flag, Willis McKenzie fires. Let's see what's going to happen. Can Tyler Brown, 25 laps, can he work his way back up? They're bouncing around off the back. See how it goes. Wally Fowler has took the lead. Willis McKenzie looking around him. Running second. Followed by Potts in the four. Parks is sitting here working on Sullivan for that four spot. Potts just got washed up. Sullivan sitting there taking away.
Carlson.
Number four.
Four car, you're gonna try to get flat tire last. Think you're gonna match a win if you are, please.
The Bubba Shaw has got a right rear flat, bringing out the caution. All right, we're waiting on the green. Green is up. To number four, Wally Fowler has fired. Willis McKenzie in second. Joe Sullivan in four. Potts, Parks, Disher, Stefani, Brown. cucumbers. There we go. A lot of them are having the problems coming out of turn two to the back stretch with a little hop there. Like we still got some going on toward the back. Is that Tyler Brown? He's trying to come through the field, but he's getting held back by Stefani and Dishers. He sits here and tries to find a way around them. Can he sit there and get the high side and go around him? He sits there and he passes Disher. He is slowly moving up. He now is past Stefani. Tyler Brown is on the move, but in the meantime, it's still Fowler, McKenzie, Sullivan, Potts, Parks. Now Brown has now made it up. Brown has made up in the sixth, and he seemed to have found the right spot to go as he takes that high side to try to avoid that sit there, that little bump there as you come off of 2-1 to the back stretch. And here he goes. He's sitting there. He has passed Potts. He is moving on up. He's getting ready to pass Parks. Parks cuts him off. Tyler Brown still gets right up there on him as they go into the turn. He jumps to the inside of Parks. Here we go. Tyler Brown had just sat here, just took that Lee Spring bad monkey's race car of Mark Milford. He had just sat there and brought that car up into the fourth position. Let's see if he can get ready to take third on Joe Sullivan. Here we go. He is looking here. There has got that Lee Spring car, that coil spring car is dialed in. But Wally Flower, he needs to be getting himself together because he is sitting there. Has got Willis McKenzie behind him. Then Tyler Brown has made his way back to third. 25 laps. They're running. We should be a good ways into the books on this one. Wally Fowler, that cagey veteran, he knows this track. Just as good as a lot of these other guys does, as he used to run here back in the days when we used to park in the pits. Willis McKenzie the same way. Tyler Brown, he has ran Modoc a few times through the Southern Outlaw Super Street Series. Had to sit here and he's about to catch Willis McKenzie. We're getting ready to come up into lap traffic. Wally Fowler has caught the lap car, the 411 car of Tommy Yates. Tyler Brown is now caught Willis McKenzie as they go up under the 411 car of Yates as they put him a lap down. We still got Joe Sullivan in fourth, Greg Parks in fifth, followed by Potts. Stefani and Disher sit there and get together the 3 and the 41. Green to go this time by.
Green.
Wally has fired. Willis McKenzie lost a little ground to him, but Tyler Brown is right there on McKenzie's bumper. Joe Sullivan's looking to see what's going to happen. Let's see how it goes. Tyler gets ready to try to go to the inside of McKenzie. Tyler, Brown, Willis McKenzie. They go into 3 and 4. Let's see how it's going to go. Tyler Brown has made it into second place. He has got that bad monkey race car on the rail. Let's see if he can catch Wally Fowler now. They go down the back straightaway. He has made a couple car lengths on him. Let's see what happens. Can he make up any more ground as they go into 3 and 4? Wally seems to be backing it down some into the turns. Tyler Brown right there gave him a challenge, but he was not able to take him at the flag stand.
There you go.
Here he goes. He goes to the inside. They both go to the inside. Drag race down the back straightaway. Wally Fowler has pulled away from him. Let's see what happens, though.
Caution
on the straightaway. But Tyler Brown has now made it to second place. He is now sitting in second now after this start. Is this going to be the caution he needs?
Green.
Followed by Parks in the 28. Potts into 4, 16 of Sullivan, 3 of Chris Gables. A lot of them are having a hard time maneuvering coming out of 2 onto the back stretch. Gables Gables, McCumbers battling in the backfield, but here we go. Sullivan is trying to catch Potts, but Potts managed to pull away. Fowler has been caught by Brown. The question is can he hold off Brown enough? Brown is on his bumper. It's all in how you come off that. Off of two onto the back straight was the main thing about it.
Caution
on the track.
Three car, you're done. Your right front is broke, sir. Pull her up on the track. You can get her off the racetrack. You will be done for the night. Your right front is broke.
Green flag is up. Wally Fowler is killing them on the start, but Tyler Brown has been able to wind them in. We've got side-by-side action between Potts and Sullivan. Let's see what happened. Can Tyler slowly wind him in? The laps have got to be winding down some. It seems like Wally seems to be breaking a little bit more in the turns, and it's allowing Tyler Brown to help make that distance up. Tyler Brown has caught him. Like I said, Tyler's done figured something out, especially when it goes to coming across to come out on the two onto the back straight, but he has now caught him. He almost got to the inside of him, but Wally didn't let him have it. Fowler, Brown, McKenzie, Potts, McCumbers.
Halfway this time by, guys. Halfway this time by.
Sullivan, Kissinger, Yates, halfway. We are halfway, and Tyler Brown is starting to work on him. He knows they're halfway into the books of 25. He gets up there to his rear quarter pound, but doesn't quite have what it takes. Let's see what Fowler does into the turns. Here we go. Brown is trying him. He is on his bumper. They have pulled away from McKenzie running third. Brown to the inside. Let's see what happens. He loses him a little bit coming off of two onto the back chute. But as they go into three, let's see what can happen. Can he make up the ground? Tyler's trying to find a way as he knows he's probably down to at least 10 laps to go. He's wanting that money bad. He's wanting that $1,722 and that 7th Annual Jackson Rip Memorial Trophy. Look at there. He had him. He had him, but
that's a race.
He managed to still come by. Fowler managed to hold him down, but let's see what happens as they go back into Brown getting ready to try him again. He gets it to his rear quarter panel. He backs off of him. They come up on the lap car, the 411, as they fight to get around him. Laps are winding down. Can Brown do it? He has almost got beside him again. Let's see how it goes as they drag race down the back straightaway. Fowler just seemed to have a little bit more for him. Lee Spring versus Coal Spring Nation right here, 1 and 2. McKenzie still holding third. Brown, Fowler. Brown has taken the lead. Can he hold it now? Fowler goes to get back up under him. Tyler shoots the door on him. Tyler Brown has taken the lead, followed by Wally Fowler in second. McKenzie still third. They're battling some more. Let's see what happens. Them two guys are putting on a show for the money here. Both of them have got at stake that trophy, saying that they won the 7th Annual Jack Surrett Memorial, as well as the trophy, the bragging rights, and the $1,722. These two guys are not giving up. They're getting ready to encounter some more lap traffic. Of two more cars, it looks like it might be caution on the...
Go high.
We've got a caution in four. Second through fifth is still going to need to be carrying $100 extra home in there. Regular payout of the purse, thanks to some fine sponsors. Tyler Brown is managing to get... Caution in turn four. Having to wave off the restart. And the green flag is down. They're up and going. Brown has done it. Fowler shows he has a motor as he is sitting there and he tried to get up on his bumper. Now it's all to see who, he tried to get up under him, but it's all seeing who can negotiate through the turns. Fowler lost a little bit of ground. The 411 has came into the pit, so four down, four to go. Tyler, Brown, Fowler. Something has happened to McKenzie. Something has happened to McKenzie with about three laps to go.
96 out on that lap.
So now it is Brown.
Caution
flag out. Right here toward the end of it. The lap. Brown, Fowler, Potts, McCumbers, Kissinger. Your top five cars. He tried him on the top side, but wasn't able to get him. Brown held him off, but here he comes. Wally's not going to let this one go down without a fight. Brown, Fowler, Potts, McCumbers, Kissinger, are your top five. Uh-oh, look at here, we got a dog fight. Now, Fowler has made it around Brown. And in the meantime, Brown has got back in the second, but can he catch Fowler? White flag coming up. White flag is up for Fowler, Brown, Potts, McCumbers, Kissinger. Can Brown catch him? He's going to have to make up a lot of ground. And it looks like your winner is going to be Fowler, Brown, Potts, McCumbers.
All cars to the scales,
please. Kissinger, McCumbers is your top five. We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight for the 7th annual Jack's Rich tomorrow. I'm at Memorial tonight. Sorry about that. It's been a long night. We have sat here. We managed to get the race over with at a good time. Be safe going home. If you've had too much to drink, have your designated driver. As always, be getting ready. Pay attention to our Facebook page as we get ready to start posting on the events coming up and who's going to be our shows for the May race.
Y'all